The two men stopped in a stand of timber a couple hundred yards from the ranch house.
There she is. Got any plans?
Start shooting.
The house and outbuildings?
Burn them to the ground.
You a hard youngin', Smoke?
I suppose I am. But I had a good teacher, didn't I?
Yeah, you had the best around.
Smoke and Preacher dismounted from their horses. Smoke moved to a small opening in the stand of trees.
Casey! Get out here!
Who are you?
Smoke Jensen.
Lousy shot. Shit, I guess he ain't that bad.
You tuck him in that ravine over there. I think I'll ease around to the back.
I'll stay here and worry him some. You be careful.
Don't worry.
Of course not. Why in the world would I do that?
Preacher glanced up at the sky.
7, maybe 8 hours till dark.
We'll be through before then.
Smoke slipped into an arroyo that half-circled the house, ending up at the rear of the ranch house. 50 yards behind the house, he found cover in a small clump of trees and settled down to pick its targets. A man got careless inside the house and offered part of his forearm on a sill.
My arm!
In front of the house, Preacher found the target and cut loose with his Henry. Smoke ducked down in the small thicket of trees.
You hands! You sure you want to die for Casey? A couple of your buddies already bought it a few miles back. One of them wearing a black shirt.
Your daddy ride with Mosby?
That's right.
Your brother named Luke?
Yeah. He was shot in the back of the gold he was guarding stolen.
Potter shot him, not me. You got no call to do this. Ride on out and forget it.
Get fired, hell damn! Jensen! The name is Barry! I come from Nevada! Didn't have nothing to do with no war! Never been no further east than the ladder in Kansas! Another fella here is the same as me! We herd cattle! Don't get no fighting wages! You let us ride out!
Get your horses and ride on out!
Barry and his partner got on their horses and had just made it to the center of the backyard.
Nice folks in there. Shot their own men in the back. Makes me want to kill them even more.
Smoke followed the arroyo until the bunkhouse was between him and the main house. In a pile behind the bunkhouse, he found sticks and rags. In the bunkhouse, he found a jar of coal oil. He tied the rags around a stake, soaked it in coal oil, lighted it, then tossed it onto the roof of the ranch house. Smoke waited, Henry at the ready, while the house slowly caught on fire. The room started filling with fumes and smoke. One man broke from the cabin on Preacher's side of the house. Another man raced from the back door towards Smoke. Only one man appeared to still be shooting from the house. Two on the range, at least two hit in the house, and two in the yard. That did not add up to 8, but maybe Smoke thought they had hit more in the house than they had thought.
All right, Casey. Burned to death, shot, or hung. It's up to you.
Casey waited until the roof was caving in before he stumbled into the yard, eyes blind from fumes.
You son of a bitch! I'll kill you!
When Casey's pistol was empty, Smoke walked up to the man. Casey was out cold. Smoke began tying his hands behind him with rawhide.
What do you figure on doing with him?
I intend to take him just outside of town. By the creek, and hanging.
Lord, I just can't figure out where you got that mean streak, boy. Seeing as how you was raised, well, at least partly, by a gentle old man like me.
Graphic Audio, a movie in your mind.